Hi guys, I'm I. Today we're going to be playing football. It's the Indianapolis Colts and the Kansas City Chiefs. I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my stay. Stay with the flu. Always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new. Praying until I need another pee. Gotta make the right decision. No, it might just be my life. People view everything different when you're touching on the fact. What you see at the...
Today, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis, this is the National Football League. Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs taking on Carson Wentz and the Indianapolis Colts.
First opened back in 2008, there's a look at Lucas Oil Stadium here in downtown Indy. Today we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Kansas City Chiefs.
I gotta kick it.
Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Indianapolis. Here's Isaiah Rogers to return. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
Varsity team.
Throwing on first is Wentz. He's got his target. That's Zach Pascal. And they're able to get this one across the...
My team is Kansas City.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw is Wentz. Complete to Hilton. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Recovery, it's Mahomes. And that's nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Well, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Meanwhile, Mahomes' throw caught by his receiver Hill.
How many yards are you?
Entering the exhibition play now. Spain has 6 touchdowns.
One of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice...
And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire from 17 yards out. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of the season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
Extra point by Butker is on target.
7-0.
7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And these guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That could be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Second down, another run with Taylor. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at
and Kansas City is going to make up that loss to the Indianapolis Colts in week three.
Wentz now to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast.
Jalen Watson.
But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they have to give up the football again after this one.
Hardman on a return. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Now Edwards-Helaire. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Here's second and a yard. On the
Mahomes. Oh! No.
He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time. And it's third and short.
Nowadays, quarterbacks don't mind throwing in the coverage.
I ain't letting that happen.
Their receivers to come down with the ball.
I ain't letting that happen.
You have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hill. And he'll end up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first.
Go, go.
All you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of a five.
And these two hooked up on a nice game to play before, and I always admire play callers that see a play that works and go right back. So they went right back to him. The reward, they're set up with first and goal.
And he gets him a little bit closer and takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. One more time with Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get about 3 yards closer. He's down about the 2.
Not the kind of game that we're crazy for, but it's the kind of game that you need to have. When you're running back in the NFL and Clyde Edwards-Helaire with that low center of gravity and strength, he's going to get those tough, gritty yards for you when necessary.
And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. Now the Chiefs bring on their field goal unit for the right hash, and this one just a chipping. Butker's kick here is good. And the lead moves to 10-10. Touchdown on their opening drive and 3 more
yards to their first quarter
lead. Everything's going according to plan so far because the offense has moved the ball, defense able to do their job, and here the special teams unit comes through with their contribution. A field goal to make it 10-0.
Rodgers on the return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Colts now, they're ready to get the football back. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
And the Chiefs are going to get him. The Mississippi State.
My man, Chris Jones.
Protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Ten nothing to score after one.
10-0 to score.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. Short completion, just 4 yards. And it'll be a third and about 13.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Into the secondary, past the 40. And all the way out to the 45-yard line.
Come on, Tyrone.
But this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
We should get the ball first.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory.
Bro, we should get the ball first.
Down on the field. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Lynn's going to give this to Taylor. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and two. His first carry. Yeah, he will have a first down here at about the 40.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously
Fumble him, didn't it?
And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. This is throw taken in by Pascal.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. On second down, it's Taylor. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
Come on, we get. Come on, Kansas City got some score.
First and 10. The give to Taylor. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Meanwhile, Wentz's throw completely to Doyle.
Why is he wide open?
Because of zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open.
No, skip to him in the warning.
And pick up a first down.
Skip to him in the warning. We don't got time for that.
Throwing his Wentz to the goal line, but it's incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those.
And he is going to go down back at the 11-yard line. The sack comes from Anthony Hitchens. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal?
He can't do that. He can't do that.
Michael Pittman there to make the grab.
Oh my gosh.
And the Colts able to get this back with a touchdown. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good.
It's 10, Doug.
The lead is down to a field goal. Sanchez.
Exactly.
Following the touchdown.
Exactly. David Allen. They just let him score.
Pringle now to return it. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. And now here comes Kansas City. Still more than a minute to go, so yeah, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well, so that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines, hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
On first down, Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
They'd love to just drive it.
not tiring.
Run some plays, run some clock.
This is caught inside the 15. All the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 61 yards. And the Chiefs strike quickly here for 6 points.
Extra point.
How many yards do we got?
1, 2, 3, 2.
Touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And here's Rodgers to return. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Colt offense and T.Y. Hilton making their way back out. With them losing here in the second quarter and his limited productivity so far, you'd have to think they're going to try to look to him a little bit more, right?
I would guess you would start to see maybe some quick screens, some hitches, anything to get the ball in his hands quickly and let him try and do some damage after the catch. Or maybe just flip some formations and keep him isolated where it's more of a one-on-one route and get the ball to him.
I said just 4 verts, right?
Hey, why not? 4 verts. One of the best routes in football. Hard to cover each guy.
Please. Please.
So far, just 1 catch for him.
Yes.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating? The guys who just gave up that play.
Here's Wentz to throw. Out to the right and complete to Pittman. On a gain of 3 on the play. And it'll be 3rd and 10.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And I think the Chiefs have it. They do. And he brings it back. Can you believe it? An offensive disaster on the final play of the first half.
They just had to hold on to the ball.
Butker now to add the extra point. This a 3-score game as the lead moves to
24-7. It's 24-7.
It's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. This taken in at the goal line. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would want it. They had success throwing it. But I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys are lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime. So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays. But I would love to watch a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run that ball in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They'll swing this complete out to Hill. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Oh my gosh, he's fast.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And he works.
gets it past the 30, almost to the 25. 50 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
A nice pick out down to the 21.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. They go play fake. Mahomes will drop that off to Edwards-Helaire. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed in the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with 2nd and goal coming up. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Jarek McKinnon. A 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs take the opening kickoff of the third quarter.
Jarek McKinnon.
Right down the field to extend their lead.
Jarek McKinnon.
See, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point because you got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver.
I'm on 4-2.
Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. And this is going to be caught. It's good.
32-7.
By 2 more.
But I guess when you're hot, you're hot. I mean, just go ahead and take the extra point and move on, but apparently they got something to prove. Almost feels like something was said this week, and they wanted to make sure that they laid it on them in this game.
Rodgers on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive. Then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
No.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly.
That now what happened?
You just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
On 2nd down, it's Taylor. Pushes him over. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Running lens ran a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Wentz now on 1st down. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Wentz going to throw. Now he's taken down. A Chiefs sack. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of 7.
So one quick easy.
I think it's 3rd down.
They struggled too far. They keep putting themselves in 3rd and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
I think it's 3rd down.
Offensive film session tomorrow, maybe a little longer.
Yeah, 3rd and 17. 3rd down and 17.
Positive grades will be handed out thus far.
On 3rd down, Hines. And he's able to break out a run tackle, but then quickly brought down. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on 4th down. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Here's Hardman to return. Loose football. And the Colts pick it up. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Give to Taylor. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up the touchdown.
Yeah, intercepted.
It's intercepted. It's a linebacker, Tyron Matthew. And the Chiefs will take over here just shy of the 30. That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback. He expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you can see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
Able to shake free for about 7 up to the 35. 3 quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Mahomes going to throw. And get this into the hands of Hill. Complete. Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
Man, I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
Extra point by Bunker is on target, and the lead will swell by one more. Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays. The long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. Now after the touchdown, here's Bunker on to kick it away. And here's Rodgers to return. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Monty is Kansas City.
The Colts offense gets
39-7. 39-7.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free. Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent, as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Fighting Hilton on his slant. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Again, it's Wentz. And he goes right back the way of Hilton. It's another 10 yards up.
Entering exhibition
drills. You can see the time and effort they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen. This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the red zone now, Wins. He's got Jack Doyle. Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8. 2nd and 2, first down marker at the 8. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. The Colts on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. And they're going to get him. They bring him down and sack back at the 16-yard line. Tyron Matthew, normally known for the pass coverage, this time a sack. Blankenship's kick is good.
into still a very large 29-point deficit.
39-10.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
First and 10. We will start at the 32.
Ready to take over. We've got a lopsided game. I don't know, Charles. What does the handbook say that we discuss when we've got a game like this in the fourth quarter?
Hold a second. Let me thumb to the proper page on that. Notice says, what? Let's discuss how we got here. This is a dominant performance, where they took control of this game, how they've managed to keep control of this game, and then we go ahead and think about how we're going to leave here and get to the airport. And a lopsided blowout, the runs are usually over.
Pass is taken in by Hill. They're running with power here. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now.
46-10.
Four touchdown passes. Carvino up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Rodgers on the return. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out there.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going.
It's 46-10.
Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No,
again.
You don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet him.
The Chiefs are going to get him. They overlooked that time on a safety blitz, and it winds up being dropped for a loss of 7. And you could say that is just another cherry on top for this defense and that entire team. But really, this defense has sparked what's been an impressive effort here in this one.
I noticed you used the word spark, because you're not seeing that on the other side of the ball, are you? The offense right now, the spark has left their game, and it's been because of what you described, that defensive pressure.
They'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on to punt for Indianapolis. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. The Chiefs offense and Tyreek Hill heading back out onto the field. This defense, they wouldn't mind not seeing him again for a while. 3 trips to the end zone, how about that?
I think right now, they would happily go to their general manager and say, is there any way you could get a trade for him? Can't make our team, so we can't for him anymore, because he's really out.
I don't know that mid-game thing's going to happen, but good thought. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And fights it off. This one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
We're going to set a screen with Tyreek Hill.
Looking for Hill again. This time it's complete. And they'll get him to the ground. And he has another first down. Colts 29-yard line.
I have to tell you, just keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
They'll get it once more into the hands of Hill, and they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, set up for the first
46-10.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game.
It's
46-10. That number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. So long, everybody.
Post-game report player stats.
Oh my gosh. 364 passing yards for Patrick Mahomes.
New highlights. Here, 108. One forty-nine. 240. Team player stats. Entering screen player stats. Teaming. Team Casey.
If you watch this video, make sure to like and subscribe. Bye.